हेलो क्लास 10, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 5, यूजर डिफाइंड मेथड्स। इट इज आल्सो नोन एज फंक्शंस। मेथड्स आर आल्सो कॉल्ड फंक्शंस। फर्स्ट, यूजिंग स्टैटिक मेथड्स। स्टैटिक मेथड्स कैन यूज ओनली स्टैटिक एलिमेंट्स इन इट्स ब्लॉक। द यूजर डिफाइंड एड इज नॉन स्टैटिक। Hence, for calling it is the main zero method, you need to create a user defined objects of the class. The complete process of using a static method is illustrated in the following programs. Suppose a program to find the sum of two numbers by using methods. In this chapter, I am explaining the functions about using the functions into a programs. So this is the programs use to find the sum of two numbers by using methods or functions. First we will write import java util. This line used for scanner package. Then public static class, public class name is sum, declaring a class as you know. Then curly bracket start. Now next line, public static int add. We will not write public static void main. This is the line, public static int add. In add, this is the function name. Now we will declare the element, two elements, because in this program we want two numbers, so that int m and int n. This is the header of the method, static method. This is known as static methods. Now we will write the function. This is the method block or body of the methods. Int s. This is the sum, int s is equal to 0. We don't know the sum of the number, so that we will write int s is equal to 0. Now we will write the formula of sum. Sum s is equal to m plus n. This is m plus n, then terminator. Now return s. We will not write system out println s. Here we are doing the programs based on the function, so that we will write return s. Return s means this is the returning value after sum of two numbers. Now curly bracket closed. Then we will start the program. First we will call the functions in starting of the program. After that we will start the our program, like public static void main string args, then curly bracket, scanner in is equal to new scanner system dot in. Then we will take two numbers. First we have taken int m and int n, but now we will take int a comma b and p. A first number, b second number, and p is the sum of the number. Then system out println enter two numbers. Same way we will enter the numbers. After that we will write the data type of the number. A is equal to int dot next int and b is equal to int dot next int. Then we will write this then we will call the object sum ob is equal to new sum. This is we are calling the object sum ob is equal to new sum. Then p is equal to ob dot add and add a comma b, because these are the two numbers. So this is the calling static methods add, invoking methods add. This invoke the functions of adding of the two numbers. Now you will enter the system out println the sum of two numbers, and the sum is in the form of p. So we will print the p here, then curly bracket close. This is the methods calling function, methods calling programs. In methods calling program, first we will write the methods which we are finding in the program. After that we will start the programs. Now there are two parameters, actual parameters and formal parameters. The parameters described in the method header, which receive the values from its caller method, are called formal parameter. That is known as the formal parameter. These are the header parameters. Whereas the value is actually passed to the method at the time of its call from the main, when we are calling main methods, functions are known as actual parameter. That is known as the actual parameters. here I am explaining in the program what is the actual parameter and what is the formal parameter. First we will write import Java. This program is same. We are finding the sum of two numbers, then writing import Java util, calling a scanner package as you know, public class sum, declaring a class name, then curly bracket start, public static int add, this is the function name add, and we are taking two number int m and int n. Int m and int n, this is the header of the method, static method. This is known as the static methods. Now int m and int n, these are the formal parameter which are declare in the header of the method, static methods, that is known as the formal parameter. Then int s is equal to 0, we don't know the sum, s is equal to m plus n, then return s, this is the calling, then curly bracket close. Now public static void main string args, then scanner in is equal to new scanner system dot in, same way int a comma b comma p, two numbers we have entered, then we will declare the data type of the two numbers, then sum ob is equal to new sum, this is the creating object of class sum, this is the there we are creating an object. Now p is equal to ob add a comma b, this is the caller statement, we are calling the two numbers here, so that this is known as the caller statement, and that previous int m and int n is the static statement. Now these two are the parameters are written in the caller statement. There are two parameters are known as actual parameter. Now a and b is the actual parameter, but m and n is the formal parameter. Now system out println, the sum of two numbers plus p. Hope you all understood about the formal parameter and actual parameters. Now next is different ways of in defining a function. Here we are using some many ways to defining a function. The function to find factorial of a number can be defined in the following three types. We are finding the factorial of a number. So first is receiving values and returning outcome to the caller, that is known as the parameterized methods. When receiving value and returning outcome to the caller, that is known as the parameterized methods. Suppose we are making a program import Java, this is creating a class scanner package, I told you earlier, class factorial, declaring a class, now curly bracket public int fact, because the function name is fact, because we are finding the factorial, so that we will write the function name is fact, public int fact, and int x is one parameter to receive a single value, because we are finding the factorial of a single value, so that int x is the one parameter to receive a single value. Now curly bracket start, then int f is the factorial, f is equal to 1, then comma I is for use for loop na, so that we will write I. Now for we will start the loop for, because it will find the factorial, so that we will start the loop. I started from 1 and I less than and equal to x value which we have entered. Till if we have entered 10, so loop will be going to 10th position, but if we have entered 15, that it will be run 15th position. Then I plus plus, now factorial is equal to f is equal to f multiply is equal to I. Now when we will find the factorial, then we will write f is equal to f multiply I, so that we have written like this, f multiply is equal to I. This is the same way, f is equal to f multiply I and f multiply is equal to I is the same. Now return f, because we are finding the factorial, so that return f is here, it returns an integer numbers, it returns an integer number, then curly bracket start. Now we will call the actual parameter, so that public static void main string args, then int, we will take two values n and m, and we have written 5 and m we have written 8. Then p is equal to ob dot fact, because we are finding the fact, so that p is equal to ob dot fact, and fact is we will find the fact of n, so that we will write n here. System out println, factorial of n is plus m, or q is equal to ob dot, this is the next factor. int n is equal to 5, m is equal to 8, factorial ob is equal to new factorial. Now ob dot fact n and ob dot fact n, m, sorry. These are the method fact is called by passing an integer each time. Now here we have not written it in this function, it is not returning any value here. Now third is neither receiving value nor returning outcome to the caller. That is known as non-parameterized constructor. In parameterized constructor, it will receiving the value and returning the value. But in non-parameterized constructor, it neither receiving the value nor returning the value. Same way, we will make the same program factorial. Import Java, calling a scanner package, class factorial, declaring a class. Now public void fact. Same way we will write public void fact. Void signifies non-returnable function. Here void signifies non-returnable function. And fact empty fact, there is empty parenthesis means function will not receive any value. Here we have not written value. In first program we have written int x, but here we have not written. This is empty parenthesis means function will not receiving any value. Now int n is equal to 5 and f is equal to 1. Here we will declare the value n is equal to 5 and f is equal to 1. Then we will write the loop for I is equal to 1. I is less than n is equal to n. By mistake I have written x, but it is till n it will going on I plus plus. F multiply is equal to I means f is equal to f multiply I. They both are the same. Now system out println factorial of n plus f, it will print. Then curly bracket start, public static void main string args. Then it will call the object factorial ob is equal to new factorial ob dot fact. Here calling fact function without passing any value means it will not returning the value and it will not receiving any value. Hope you all understood. Now I will explaining you passing values to a function. There are two types. These are of two types. There are two ways of passing values to a function. First is pass by value, that is also known as call by value. In this system, the value from the actual parameters are copied to the formal parameters. In pass by value or call by value, the values from the actual parameters, it will copy to the formal parameters. It is the process of passing a copy of actual parameter to the formal parameters. Any change made in the formal parameter does not reflect on the actual parameter. If we are changing in formal parameter, it will not reflect the change in actual parameters. All primitive data types such as int, float, long, double, etc. are by default passed by value. Now pass by reference. These are the second. This is also known as call by reference. In this system, references means addresses of the actual parameters and formal parameter both represent the same memory location. Both are representing the same memory location, means the location of both the parameters are same. It is the process of passing the reference address of actual parameter to the formal parameters in such a way that any change made in formal parameter will be reflected on the actual parameter. In pass by reference, if we are doing any change in formal parameter, it will reflect the changes of actual parameters also. Only these are the difference between those call by value and call by reference. Now a programmer must keep this point in mind. Call by value can be used with simple primitive data types, but call by reference must be used with non-primitive data types like class, object, array, etc. In simple primitive data types are, you know, na, int, double, string, char, all are the primitive data types. But non-primitive data types are only three: class, object, and array. Now there are two types of functions: pure functions and impure functions. A function which returns a value to its caller module is called a pure function. A function which returns a value, that is known as the pure functions. It also called assessor method, and it does not change the states of an object. It will not change the states of an object or behavior of an object. Impure functions. A function that may not return a value. It will not return a value but changes the state of an object. In pure function, it return the value but not changes the states of object. But in pure function, it will not return a value but it changes the state of an object, is known as impure method or impure functions, or that is also known as impure mutator also. That is known as assessor, and it is also known as mutator. Now we will do some programs related to the function. Suppose one first program, write a program to accept a number and check whether the number is prime or not. Use the function name. The function name is check. We will use the function name check. Int n. The function name returns 1 if the primitive prime, otherwise it returns 0. If the number is prime, it returns 0. It returns 1. If the number is not prime, it returns 0. Same way, a program to check a prime number by using function. Import Java util, public class prime, curly bracket, int check. Then int n, we will write the value also here. This function is written here, check int n. So that we will take int check int n. Now curly bracket, int I for loop, C for counting is equal to 0, and F is also for 0. Now for I is equal to 1 and I less than and equal to n, because it will run which number we have entered, then I plus plus curly bracket. Now we will find the prime number. Prime number, first we will divide that number by the loop. First position I, we will divide that by I. If it will come equal to 0, then C is equal to C plus 1. If we will divide that number by the loop value I and it will come equal to 0, then C is equal to C plus 1. Then curly bracket close. If C equal to, if C, the value of C equal to, then F is equal to 1. So that F is equal to 1 and return F here. Then return F here. Now curly bracket close. This is the functions which we are using. Now we will start the program. Public static void main string args. Int a, for that number in that we have taken n, but here we will take a. Then curly bracket k. Scanner in is equal to new scanner system dot in. Then system out println, enter your number a. Then you will write the data type of the number. Now we will create the object prime. We are taking prime. Prime ob is equal to new prime. We will write the class name same, then ob, then is equal to new, then that class name we will write here. K is equal to ob dot check a. It will checking the number is prime or not. K is equal to, it will store in the k. Then if k equal 1, if k is equal to 1, then print system out println, it is prime number. Otherwise it is not a prime number. Then curly bracket close. Now we will write the variable description. N and a, int enter the value, I int loop, C int check the number, K integer, this is for object, and F integer, this is for function. Hope you all understood this program. Now next program, write a program to accept a number and check whether the number is palindrome or not by using function name. Here we will write the function name reverse. Int n, the function returns the reverse number to the main program that check the palindrome number. First we will write the message, then palindrome, public class palindrome, int reverse, function name are written here, so that we will take int reverse and int n is here. Then curly bracket, int d and r is equal to 0. Do, we will use the do while loop. So do starting d for the modulus of the number. D is equal to, first we will divide that number by the 10 and we will store the modular. These are the two programs which I have explained. Students, you will complete your work on time. If you have any problem, you can ask me through mail. You will try to understand this program. Students, this is my advice. You will see complete video and you will read this chapter from your book also. If you have any problem, you can ask me through mail. Some of the students are not doing their work. This is a very bad student. You will complete your work at time and submit your work on time, because you know this assignment are also decide your result. So you will submit your work on time. I am repeating again and again, complete your work and submit your work on time. Thank you.